Marvel has been teasing a huge Spider-Man reveal on their Twitter. It's got the internet a-talkin', and we think we know what it is. We're gonna break that down, plus I wanna go over the Nova and Guardians of the Galaxy 3 rumor.
It's like the news, but for nerds. Subscribe so you never miss an episode.
Today's shout-out goes to Johnny Skiles Jr. Indeed, Brad Pitt was the Vanisher in Deadpool 2. Make sure you stay to the end of this video where we will ask another nerd card question. What's up, everybody? Happy Tuesday to you. I'm, of course, Josh. This is the Den of Nerds, and you are you, whoever you are. And you have probably heard about this crazy Spider-Man teaser, the thing that Marvel Studios has put out on their Twitter. This dropped on Sunday with the number 4 in webbing. And the tweet seems to tease something that no one will see coming. This thing blew up, man. People were talking about this. Executive producer Al Schuler hit me up as soon as it dropped. A lot of people were hitting us up on social media through the DMs or just commenting on posts. And there were two incredibly popular theories as for what this was. Number one, people thought it could be a comic book adaptation of the 4th and scrapped Sam Raimi Spider-Man film. And the other big theory was that this was going to be some kind of a tie-in between the Fantastic Four and Spider-Man, that there's gonna be some kind of crossover, perhaps a big event with the Fantastic Four and Spider-Man crossing over. And editor-in-chief of Marvel Comics, C.B. Sobolski, came out and pretty much slapped down the two most popular theories as for what this tease could be. Wait. So it's not a Spider-Man FF crossover? You mean it's not a comic book adaptation of Spider-Man 4? I told you, you will not see this one coming. Now, the current speculation on this is that it's just a countdown to a big comic book event being announced by Marvel Comics. This event will circle around Spider-Man and probably have something to do with this masked, mysterious villain that's been popping up in the current run of Amazing Spider-Man. There was also a slate of what big comic book events were coming to Marvel in 2019 announced earlier this year, and the December event was left blank. So that's what people were thinking that that December thing is gonna be the Spider-Man thing. Bet you didn't see that coming, except now that you watched this video, you did. Now, we should be clear, we don't know that that is what the announcement will be, and it could be something really freaking cool, like the crossover between the MCU and the comic books, which is something I've kind of been thinking was really gonna, could be really cool. But either way, this is Marvel once again adding a lot of buzz and getting a lot of attention on something comic book related, seemingly playing off of the recognition and the hype surrounding the movies. I mean, consider the fact that the Spider-Man Far From Home social media embargo lifts tomorrow, so we'll start seeing a lot of sort of reviews pop up online. We'll probably talk about that here on this show. Marvel will likely release more TV spots and trailers for Far From Home this week and in the coming week. So Spider-Man's gonna be trending this week and next week and into its release. So it's really smart for them to tease this when there's a lot of hype around Spider-Man due to the film. And for the record, Thursday is when this countdown ends, so we will know what it is on Thursday, and we'll probably report about that this week too. So this is really smart by Marvel. I think this is pretty clever, getting a lot of attention on the comic books, sort of tentpole marketing around the hype based around these films. And they've done this recently with the X-Men as well. We've been talking about X-Men comics more than ever on this channel recently because of how it could possibly tie into the MCU. And that teaser that Marvel did on their Twitter with the redacted files that you could find through that link, and people thought it was a leaked kind of teaser for the MCU X-Men and Captain America meeting up. Yeah, all this stuff is very smart. I wanna say good job to Marvel, but I just hope that it's backed up with incredible comics, like really, really good stuff. If that does indeed happen, this could be the sign of sort of a reawakening for Marvel Comics, maybe a start to trend forward, getting more attention on these books, getting more quality books out there, and getting more people reading comics. I'm cool with this. It's getting people interested, though I do think it will wear off eventually and people will be able to know, okay, this is just comic book stuff, unless Marvel does something really interesting to tie it to the MCU, which I'm hoping they do. And so I'm really curious, what do you guys think this tease is for the Spider-Man announcement? Do you think it's just gonna be this new event? You think it's some kind of crossover with the MCU? What do you think's going on there? And are you personally getting more interested in checking out Marvel Comics because of some of these interesting tactics Marvel is using to promote the new stuff? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Now, lastly, before we get out of here, I want to go over this crazy rumor on Reddit all about Nova and the Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3 film. The Marvel Scoopmaster, who we talk about quite a bit here on this channel, is now saying that Nova will be introduced in Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3 and then spun off into his own movie later. Not exactly earth-shattering news, but I did actually call this a couple of weeks back, so I wanted to mention it. You know, when all of these rumors were floating around about a Nova movie being developed, and a Guardians of the Galaxy 3 movie being developed, I speculated that it would probably go the route where Nova was in Guardians of the Galaxy 3 and then they did a Nova movie, which I think is dope, and I called that. Now, we won't see either of these movies for several years. I mean, James Gunn is still developing and working on the Suicide Squad 2, which is kind of going to be more of like a Suicide Squad reimagining or reboot. Whatever it is, it's going to be dope, and I'm really glad that he's doing it, actually, so I'm looking forward to that. But a lot of his time is going to be taken up doing that, and then he will eventually come back to write and direct Guardians of the Galaxy 3, which apparently already has sort of a spec script. You remember, this was a point of contention among the cast because after Gunn was removed as director, a lot of them still wanted them to use Gunn's script for Guardians of the Galaxy 3. So there's a script out there that James Gunn has for Guardians of the Galaxy 3. A lot of the hype online recently surrounding Marvel has really been in the way of rumors and speculation on what will be announced at San Diego Comic-Con later this year and at D23. We're all anticipating a lot of crazy announcements, things to get very hyped on, so make sure you are subscribed to this channel and have notifications enabled, because we're going to be going over all of that information as we get closer to D23 and, of course, San Diego Comic-Con. Now, let's check the nerd card before we get out of here. I want to know, what is the name of the famous place where all of the big comic book movies reveal themselves at San Diego Comic-Con? It's a certain section of San Diego Comic-Con that's now become famous for how it, you know, delivers comic book goodness to all of us nerds. So what is the name of that place at San Diego Comic-Con where all the comic book movie goodness goes down? Answer that question in the comment section below. As I always say, I hope you're having an awesome and a nerdy day, and I'll see you in the next video.